Welcome to the lecture series of Z transform. In our previous video we have discussed about initial value theorem and final value theorem. Now the continuation of that we can see some problems under initial value and final value theorem. Look at the question. Find the initial and final value of the sequence f of n if f of z equal to 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 minus 0.25 z power minus 2. So for the given sequence, we need to find the initial value and final value. When we were discussed about the initial value theorem and final value theorem, look at this. F of 0 is denoting initial value of the given sequence and f of infinity is denoting final value of the sequence. Now in this question, we need to find the initial value and final value. That means we need to find f of 0 and f of infinity for given f of z. So this is the statement of initial value theorem and final value theorem. So first we will go with the initial value theorem. So we know that f of 0 equal to limit n tends to 0, f of n equal to limit z tends to infinity f of z. This is our initial value theorem. Now the given f of z, what is our given f of z? Given f of z equal to 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 minus 0.25 z power minus 2. So in our statement we have that f of 0 equal to limit n tends to 0 f of n equal to limit z tends to infinity f of z. So in the question also given f of z. So what we are going to do is we are going to allow the z tends to infinity. Okay, so allow the limit z tends to infinity 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 minus 0.25 z power minus 2. Actually this z power minus 1 means what? Z power minus 1 means 1 by z, and here 1 by z square. Z power minus 2 means 1 by z square. When we are allowing the limit z tends to infinity, what will happen? 1 by infinity, anything by infinity value is 0, and here also this will become as 0. So the first z power minus 1 will become 0 and this term will also become 0. So we can get only the term as 1 by 1, which is equal to 1. Therefore, what is our f of 0? F of 0, that is our initial value, limit z tends to infinity, capital F of z equal to 1. This is our initial value. Now for the second result, final value. Look at the final value, f of infinity equal to limit n tends to infinity f of n equal to limit z tends to 1 z minus 1 into f of z. So f of infinity equal to limit z tends to 1 z minus 1 into f of z. So because given function or given sequence is f of z, so limit z tends to 1 z minus 1 into given f of z 1 plus 1 by z, that is z power minus 1, and 1 minus 0.25 into 1 by z square. Now what we are going to do is we are going to allow the limit z tends to 1. So in this term 1 minus 1 will become as 0, 0 into anything will become as 0. So obviously our final value answer is 0. So initial value, that is f of 0 is 1 and f of infinity is 0. This is what the answer for the first question. Look at the second question. Find the initial and final value of the sequence f of n if f of z equal to z by 2 z square minus 3 z plus 1. This question is also similar to the previous one. So first we'll write the initial value. So by initial value, by initial value theorem, we know the initial value is f of 0. F of 0 equal to limit n tends to 0, f of n equal to limit z tends to infinity, capital F of z. This is what the statement of initial value theorem. Now we have to find the value of f of 0 for the given f of z. So which is equal to limit z tends to infinity, we'll write the given f of z, z by 2 z square minus 3 z plus 1. This is what the given f of z. Look at this f of z, numerator and denominator. In both the places we are having z. When you are applying z tends to infinity, this will become as infinity by infinity form. So in this case, what we have to do? We have to apply L'Hospital rule. So this will become as infinity by infinity form. So apply L'Hospital rule. What is L'Hospital rule means? Differentiating numerator and denominator separately. That is called it as L'Hospital rule. So differentiating and numerator and denominator separately. So when we are differentiating our numerator, this will become as 1. Differentiation of z with respect to z is 1. When you are differentiating here, we can get actually 2z square. That means 4z minus 3. So first we will write this one. Limit z tends to infinity 1 divided by 4z minus 3. Now we are applying the limit z tends to infinity. This 1 is constant. Differentiation of constant is 0. So what will happen when we are applying the limit z tends to infinity? Anything by infinity. What is that? Anything by infinity is 0. So the answer will become as 0. So what is our f of 0? Initial value answer is 0. Now we are going for the final value. What is our final value theorem? F of infinity by final value theorem. F of infinity equal to limit n tends to infinity. F of n is equal to limit z tends to 1 z minus 1 into capital F of z. This is what our final value theorem. So now what we are going to do is we are going to apply our F of z here. So which is equal to limit z tends to 1 z minus 1 into capital F of z. It's given in the question z by 2z square minus 3z plus 1. This is what our f of z. Now when you are applying the limit z tends to 1, what will happen? 0 by 0 form will occur. So this will become as 0 by 0 form. So in this case also, we have to apply L'Hospital rule. So when you are applying that, what will happen here? Limit z tends to... By applying L'Hospital rule, what is that L'Hospital rule? Differentiating with respect to z, numerator and denominator separately. That is called it as L'Hospital rule. So now we are going to differentiate this. Limit z tends to 1, 2z minus 1. For the differentiation numerator, and then when you are differentiating this, we can get 4z minus 3. This 1 is a constant. Differentiation of constant is 0. Now we are going to allow the limit z tends to 1. So what will happen here? It is 2 minus 1. For this place we are making 1. So 2 into 1 2, 2 minus 1 divided by 4 into 1. So 4 minus 3. That is equal to 1 by 1, which is equal to 1. Therefore, our final value answer is 1. So, initial value answer is f of 0 equal to 0. And our final value answer is f of infinity equal to 1. This is what the answer for the second question. Thank you for watching.